story begins with a boy named Jack, who not so long ago lived in a humble funk shack. All was well in the little town of Bethlefunk, until one day there appeared a lonely monk. "People of Bethlefunk, I bring terrible news to you all. It appears we have suffered a great fall. Your town is missing a distinct element of life. If it is not restored, I can promise only great strife. In the little town of Bethlefunk, the people all smell of the skunk. Little Jack knew not of this gunk, for little Jack, he had no funk. Every night, when they closed their eyes, the villagers feared the skies. For in the skies were their greatest fears, funkless giants lurking near. Their wretched chants haunted through the night. It plagued their ears and caused great fright. And when they all went to their beds, that mystic chant ran through their heads. Fee, fi, fo, funk. I smell the blood of a funky monk.
Fee, fi, fo, funk. I smell the blood of a funky monk. Fee, fi, fo, funk. I smell the blood of a funky monk. Fee, fi, fo, funk. I smell the blood of a funky monk. Fee, fi, fo, funk. I smell the blood of a funky monk.
A monster! For Jack's path was blocked by a terrible
giant!
Jack knew at once. To leave this place, he must do battle with such a creature. Jack must duel the terrible giant. The giant said,
choose your weapon.
And then Jack said, I choose funk. Let out his last terrible cry. He said, his last funkless roar. Jack stood over the soul of the slain beast. Something changed in Jack that day, for little Jack had found his funk.